welcome to our Ohana friends and visitors. Please follow along with the order of worship that's on the screen in front of us. The West Hawaii Ministry Association will be hosting a combined Monday-Thursday foot-washing worship service on April 14th at 6:30 p.m. at the Salvation Army in Hanapepe, and all of us are welcome. Tropic Care is coming to Kauai again this year, and so there'll be no-cost health care coming to Kauai June 13th to the 20th. Free physical exams, free eye exams, eyeglasses, free dental exams, fillings and extractions. And more info, if you want more info, check with Pastor Nate. I suspect that Tony is heading that up again this year. I think we had to pass on it last year, maybe the year before, because of COVID. But my understanding is that this is helps the military with their training, and we're very fortunate to have them come over. We're not asking any income levels or any of that sort of thing, because the important thing is that they get their training. So they certainly encourage everyone to take advantage of it who needs to. There's now a container available for donations to make to Tonga in regards to tsunami relief. Should you wish to donate, you can drop off this off at the Lahui UMC. But it's a good idea to check with Pastor Nathi first so that he can make arrangements to have somebody there to meet you at Lahui. We'll have Easter Sunday services here in Kamakani on Sunday, the 17th of April, and that'll be at 9:30 regular time. Anybody's celebration of life will be on Sunday, the 24th of this month. And so that would be in kickoff. In an effort to ensure visibility within the community, the Church Growth Committee has ordered t-shirts that can be worn when we carry out any of the church functions and activities. The intention was to order shirts and for everyone to buy their own shirt to cover the cost. The total cost is coming to over $600. However, a t-shirt angel donated money for the first 50 t-shirts, and so that they will be available today after service. Marissa will be in the back, and those first 50 shirts will be free of charge. If there's not a size for you left available, then check with Marissa, and she can make sure that the sizes that you need get ordered in the next order. Are there any questions on the t-shirts? Thank goodness the repairs for the septic tank has all been done. Last year, as you know, the church rallied, and within, I don't know, two weeks or so, maybe a little longer, we raised over $30,000 to upgrade the Kekaha parsonage from the cesspool to septic tank. The septic tank was installed last year, but there were still some plumbing issues that needed to be resolved. We had cast iron pipe underneath the sanctuary, underneath the parsonage that was getting very old and not working well. So that was just completed. So the whole project has been done, and I think we have maybe $5,000 left over that has gone into a fund for the maintenance of the septic, because that may come up, pumping and so forth. So we're thankful to everybody for just an awesome job on that. It was amazing how that got done in such short order. And now our family living in the residence won't have to deal with some of the issues in the past. So we're very thankful. Thank everybody for it. exciting thing, potluck starts again next week. So that'll be in Cape Cod, our first potluck, but it'll be fun to gather for a meal after worship service from now on. Bible study still at 6 p.m. on Thursday afternoons via Zoom, and the link will be sent out to everyone. If you don't get a link, or if you're not on the email list, please contact Maylene, and she'll make sure that you get the link prior to the Bible study. I think the link goes out twice, one probably around Tuesday afternoon, and then another one Thursday afternoon. So you'll know if you don't get it by Wednesday that you're not on the list, and contact Maylene to get added. And then in addition, you need to contact Maylene if you have any joys, concerns, or announcements that you'd like to make. She'd appreciate it. You'd get that information to her by Friday around 6 p.m. so she has time to get it put together in the order of worship. Any other announcements? Okay. Seeing none, let's move on to our call to worship. Let's stand as we say our call to worship. Let the same mind be in you that is in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited.
But emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness.
And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross.
Therefore God highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name.
So that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, heaven and on earth and under the earth.
And every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. So let us join in singing his praise. Amen.
Well, let us stand for our first opening hymn, and the music will be played for us as we sing along. The lyrics will be on the screen.
Standing.
And Shaka or Erhut, your neighbor. Peace to Christ. Okay, now's the time for our presentation of tithes and offerings. Many stand. We'll sing together as the offering is brought forward.
Daughter's 25th birthday. Aww. And she's in Nashville celebrating. April 5th is Uncle Hermie, someone's son's birthday. April 7th is my birthday. And April 24th is Millie's, and I don't know who else.
Good job, Adele.
I only remember April.
Anyone else?
My mom's birthday was April 3rd. She would have been 120, so she wasn't in the paper.
Yeah.
Our daughter-in-law, Nastia, her birthday is on April 8th. And are we doing birthdays and anniversaries?
Yes.
And our daughter's 10th anniversary, she and her husband is on April 7th.
Awesome.
My nephew's Joshua, his birthday last week in first, and then my sister Virginia will be tomorrow. Oh.
Nice. A lot of birthdays in April. Anyone else? Anniversaries? Yeah, Esther.
Paul just made 15 months last week, the 21st. 15 months, this board.
It's not quite a birthday, but certainly something to celebrate.
Yeah.
Okay, Maestro.
Are traveling mercies joys or concerns?
Both.
Okay, because I think the travel is a joy, right? So June, I think, is going on a trip to see a Korean boy band.
Oh, yes.
What?
Yeah. And then we travel overseas for our sister Pat, who is coming back from a very nice time in San Jose.
So we celebrate for the travels. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And for safe journeys, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Anything else?
Please pray for Teresa Louis' son. He is in hospital at this time for a heart
trouble. Teresa
Louis' son.
Okay. In the hospital for heart palpitations. Okay. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Joyous concerns?
I have a friend, Karen, in Illinois. She just found out this week she has cancer.
Okay, Karen in Illinois has cancer. We pray for healing for Karen. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Just thank you to all of those who came on Wednesday to help with the Kupuna food distribution. We were able to distribute about 70 bags, and we also had help from about 6 high school students from Georgia who were able to help with the bagging. And so we had a really successful event. We look forward to the next one, so thank you all for your able to help.
Marissa wants to thank everyone for participating in the food distribution on Wednesday, and thanks to the folks from Georgia, the teams that helped in the distribution, and everyone else that would participate. It was a very successful event. We celebrate.
Praise the Lord.
Rick.
My sister and the husband are flying back from the Philippines on Friday. Travel mercy.
Travel mercies for
my sister Cinderella and her husband.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
The other joys or concerns?
Sorry, one more thing. I just wanted to say that, sorry, I was distracting. My fourth graders dropped off donations, but joy that we have friends and family who want to donate to the church.
Marissa is expressing a joy that we have friends and family that want to make donations to the church. We're just so thankful for that. We celebrate.
Praise the Lord.
Carol?
I just want to say thank you for inviting me to participate in that food drive. It was an amazing experience, very spiritual. And to be on the property, as Pastor explained to me how special that property is and how special those people are, it was just amazing to be part of it. So thank you, Carol.
Thank you, Carol. Carol's very thankful that she was able to participate in the food distribution, and it was this moving spiritual moment for her. And so, Lord, and you, we celebrate.
Praise the Lord.
Anyone else? Adele?
Just wanted to let you guys know that Anthony is doing well. He has 3 more weeks of therapy, so he's doing real good.
After Anthony's knee surgery, he's doing extremely well. He has 3 more weeks of therapy, and he should be up and about harassing Adela.
It started on March 8th.
Well, I don't know whether that's a celebration. But anyway, we celebrate.
Praise the Lord.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Randall, how about your surgery? How's that been recovered? So, we celebrate.
Praise the Lord.
Anyone else? Okay. Pastor Knopfler. Yep. Let us pray. God, the God of all creation, the God of every good and perfect gift from above. And this Lenten Sunday, we reflect on the life that you have lived, the miracles you performed, the mission of salvation that made eternal life possible to all of us. We thank you for the blessings that you outpoured onto us, the joys shared today by your church, the birthdays, anniversaries, and other celebrations. We pray that your name be praised. Lord, we confess to you all of our sins. We pray for your forgiveness. We pray for your mercy and help us to forgive those who have sinned against us. For we know that you look not into our appearances in this world, but the conditions of our hearts. Lead us into new life through your Son, Jesus Christ, who died the sins of all. Lord, we are on our knees this morning praying for giving, praying for your peace and comfort, praying for your deliverance from anything that holds us back from living the life that you have called us to have. Names of dear ones mentioned this morning, Lord, we pray for you to help. We pray for your mercy to hear our prayers. In the name of the mighty God,
consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus.
good?
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
God is awesome.
You better tell somebody.
God is awesome.
You better tell somebody.
Hey. Well, we have arrived at the fifth Sunday of this Lenten season. A season of self-reflections of one's faith. A season of deep pondering of God's working grace in our individual lives. Most importantly, a season of self-denial. Because with self-denial comes humility. And with humility comes gratitude and appreciation. Being grateful for what Jesus did for us sinners. Appreciating the life that he lived so we can imitate and learn from it. The suffering that he endured as a human so we can relate to it. And the death that he conquered to give us hope in this life and the life is yet to come in heaven. And the most amazing thing about what Jesus did for us on the cross is the fact that he did what he did for all of us. Not just a group of people, but all people. Every single one of us. In other words, Jesus was the ultimate equalizer. Because Jesus came in a time where the society was set up in a way where it was obvious who were considered righteous and who were considered sinners. You see, the righteous were the rich, the people with lots of money, the people with many titles and power, the people who pay their temple taxes in time, the people who had some ties to the founding fathers of the religion. That's, of course, in that context. That's Moses, Abraham, Jacob, Isaac, King David, etc. The people who followed the religious leaders and their laws, laws that were used to condemn and control the people instead of guide and lead. Laws in which they found loopholes so they could benefit. So what were the sinners then? The sinners were the opposite of those things I mentioned. The sinners were the marginalized, the slaves, because they were in debt to someone, the poor in money and possessions because they couldn't pay their temple taxes, the lower class of society because they had no title, therefore no honor, the ones who challenged the religious leaders and their teachings. And these are just some of the things that made a person a sinner at that time. And because of their social and religious status, they were not treated well in that society. You see, righteousness and sin were measured based on merits, social status, and a religious system of law. Well, does that mean that being rich is bad? The short answer is no. What Jesus taught us is when riches, money, or possessions become your primary priority and God becomes a secondary priority, that is when it becomes an issue. In fact, Jesus made it clear in Matthew chapter 6. He was preaching to this large crowd and he said in verse 24, it reads, "No one can serve two masters. Either you will hate the one and love the other. You will devote it to the one and despise the other." Then he ended with this beautiful line. You cannot serve both God and money. Essentially what Jesus is saying is, when you become a follower of me, when you become my disciple, make me your own.
for I have made you my own. Put me first and everything else after. Knowing what Jesus did for us because he loves us so much means he's worthy to be our priority. Amen?
Amen.
And this is what Paul, Apostle Paul, is alluding to in today's epistle. Paul was in prison in the time of this writing. In fact, he was in a very bad situation in which he awaits his trial, and death was certain if he was convicted for the Roman Empire. Nevertheless, Paul continued his ministry from prison through letters to the church. And apparently there were Jews who became Christians that entered his church in Philippi. And they started to preach things that were at odds with Paul's teachings. They even told the church members who were Gentiles that they must partake in the Jewish religious traditions to be considered a real Christian. You know, they would preach something like, well, Paul and Jesus was Jewish, therefore you must be Jewish first before you become a Christian. And our epistle today is Paul making a case against them by using himself as an example. Paul is essentially saying, you think you're good Jews? Well, wait, let me pull out my credentials. And then he started listing things that in that time, those were the standards that made a perfect Jew. And then he says, all of these achievements and titles and accolades he may have, but he counts all of them as rubbish in view of knowing Christ and having Christ's righteousness that comes through faith. You know, the Greek word for rubbish here that Paul is using in this epistle is a much stronger word. It actually means human feces. And for Paul to say that, it shows how strongly he feels about this and his commitment to follow Christ. In this season of Lent, let there be a reminder to all of us that in the eyes of Christ, we are all equal. In the eyes of Christ, our eternal life is measured not based on our merits, but our obedience to follow Christ, even in the midst of uncertainty. A couple years ago, Mel and I watched the movie Equalizer. I think maybe some of you have a picture here. The star character was Denzel Washington. And basically, the movie was about a man who sees someone get abused and mistreated by their ruthless bosses, and then decide to help her. He then continues to do this, help anyone who has a problem, has the odds stacked against them, and they have nowhere else to turn. He makes sure that they're given an equal playing field with their adversaries, that they're no longer taking advantage of. And the way that Denzel Washington went about this help was he punished the bullies, right? He made sure that they paid for what they did for these defenseless individuals. And his strategy of making sure that there's equality in this situation is to unleash the power they had over the victims onto them. Well, when we look at the mission of God this Lenten season, we see how he brought equality to this world. But he didn't do it in the Denzel Washington way. He did it in a way that was unthinkable. Instead of bringing his wrath on us, he sent his son on a sacrificial mission. A mission that was for those, mission that was not only for those of Paul's righteous, but also the unrighteous. A mission that was for those who found themselves, for those who were born with a silver spoon in their mouth, but for also for those who found themselves homeless and hungry. Everyone was the same to God. Everyone was a sinner, but even more so, everyone had to be saved. So important was to him to save everyone that he willingly gave his son to the world to be crucified. He took the punishment upon himself. He knew there was a cost to this mission, and he accepted. And as we continue journeying through this Lenten season, let us remember this. When it comes to life and eternity, there's nothing in this world that could ever make us more or less than our fellow human beings, even if we may feel that way at times. Jesus' life, death, ministry, and resurrection has made all of us equal. We are all the same in his eyes. We're all loved the same by God. He has saved all of us. Jesus is the ultimate equalizer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now let us prepare our hearts to receive the Holy Communion.
Christ our Lord, invite us to this table, all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sins and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us all confess our sins before God and one another.
Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love, and we have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us from joyful obedience to Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Let us bless the young ones. Call the Holy Spirit, let us gather with you, Lord. On these gifts of bread and wine, let them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory. We feast his heavenly banquet. Your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the Holy Church, honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. On a night in which he gave himself up for us, Jesus took the bread, gave thanks to you. Then he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat. This is my body, just given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took the cup and gave thanks to you. And then he had this with his disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood, the new covenant, poured for you and for many, for forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink, in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these mighty acts of Jesus Christ, We offer ourselves as praise and thanksgiving, as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's sufferings for us, as we proclaim the ministry, the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
This time we're going to sing the Lord's Prayer. We're going to ask
thank you.
Please join me for the benediction.
Go now in the righteousness of faith, and live our lives.